Dear friends, welcome to another project video. Today we're going to build an internet radio device with an impressive AMOLED display using an inexpensive ESP32 S3 board. Believe it or not, we can now build an internet radio in less than 10 minutes and with just about $30. There is a lot to cover, so let's get started. A few years ago, I completed this internet radio project on a breadboard. If you want to see how I built this project, you can click on the card here. The project works great, but it is a bit complicated to build, and now we can build a better version of it, which requires less parts and it is easier to build. As you can see, a first version of the project is ready on a breadboard. Let's power it up. The project connects to the internet and then streams music from predefined radio stations. Let's listen to it for a few seconds.
Στην άνοδο του Κηφισού από Εγάλεο μέχρι Νέα Φιλαδέλφια. Σημαντικές καθυστερήσεις επίσης στην έξοδο της Αθηνών στο Σκαραμαγκά.
I have tuned in to the Real FM radio station from Athens, and by using these buttons, we can change the radio station we are listening to. I have saved my favorite radio stations to the memory of the ESP32, so I can access them easily. With these buttons, I can change the volume of the speaker. I display the name of the radio station we are listening to, the time, and the Wi-Fi signal strength on this AMOLED display. Some radio stations also transmit the song title, so in this case, the song title is also displayed on the screen. The project works fine and it is very easy to build. You can build the same project in less than 10 minutes, but you need to have some experience. If this is your first project, consider building a simpler one first to gain some experience. Check my channel for simple project ideas, and where you are more comfortable with the Arduino and the electronics, come back to build this cool project. Let's now start building our own internet radio. We are going to need the following parts: a WaveSer ESP32 S3 AMOLED board, a MAX9835-7A I2S module, one 3-watt speaker, 4 push buttons, a breadboard, and some wires. The total cost of the project is around $32. Amazing stuff! We can build our own internet radio with just $32. You can find links to all the parts I use in the description of the video below. The heart of the project is, of course, this powerful ESP32 S3 board from WaveSer. I chose this board to build this project because it offers everything I wanted for this project in a single low-cost board. The board offers a powerful ESP32 S3 microcontroller along with an impressive AMOLED display. Please check out my in-depth presentation of the board to see why AMOLED displays are a game changer for do-it-yourself projects. This board also offers a built-in battery charger, so this project can be battery powered. We just connect a battery to the connector here and we are ready to go. The ESP32 S3 chip the board uses is very powerful. It is dual core and it offers Wi-Fi connectivity. The board connects to the internet and then it receives MP3 data from the radio station we are listening to. The MP3 data is then decoded inside the ESP32 chip. The ESP32 is powerful enough to decode MP3 files. The library we are using for decoding the MP3 stream requires 2 processing cores, so only the ESP32 variants that offer 2 cores work with this library. The previous internet radio project I had built used an external dedicated hardware MP3 decoder to achieve the same thing. Then we output the audio data using the I2S interface the ESP32 offers. The I2S interface is a digital audio protocol that allows the ESP32 to transmit high-quality digital audio data directly to compatible audio devices. Unlike analog audio outputs that can suffer from noise and interference, I2S maintains perfect digital audio quality throughout the transmission process. In our internet radio project, the I2S interface sends the decoded MP3 audio data from the ESP32 to the MAX9835-7A amplifier module. This module is specifically designed to receive I2S digital audio signals and convert them into amplified analog audio that can drive our 3-watt speaker. This module acts as both a digital to analog converter and an audio amplifier in one compact package. This is a very useful module for many audio projects. The beauty of using I2S is that we get crystal audio output without any of the hissing or buzzing that you might experience with cheaper analog audio solutions. The digital signal remains pristine until the very last moment, when it is converted to analog audio inside the MAX98357A module, right before it reaches the speaker. In my last project, I had significant noise issues with the audio output, so I had to add an audio isolation transformer just to eliminate the unwanted interference. But not anymore. With this digital I2S approach, the sound quality we achieve is absolutely excellent and completely noise-free. All we have to do now is to connect all the parts together according to this schematic diagram. You can find a link to it in the description of the video below. The connection is straightforward and it won't take you more than 5 minutes. There is one thing to note though, the I2S interface outputs a stereo signal, but the MAX98357A amplifier module will only play one audio channel to our single speaker. If you want true stereo output, you will need two MAX98357A modules and two speakers, one for each channel or a module that supports stereo output. The connections are ready. After successfully loading the code, let's power up the project. It takes a few seconds to connect to the internet. After connecting to the internet, the project connects to a predefined radio station. The hardware is working as expected, but now let's see the software side of the project. Before uploading this code to your ESP32 S3 board, you need to make a few important preparations. First, open the Arduino IDE on your computer. If you already have the ESP32 board definitions installed, you are good to go. You can simply select the board and start programming. However, if you haven't installed the ESP32 board definitions yet, follow these quick steps. Go to File, Preferences, and in the Additional Board Manager URLs field, enter the following URL. Click OK to save. Next, click on the Boards Manager icon here. In the search bar, type ESP32 and look for the package named ESP32 by Espressif Systems. Click Install or Update if you have an older version. Once the installation is complete, our board is ready to use. Before uploading the program, we also need to install a library. Click here to open the Library Manager and install the ESP32 I2S library. We need this library to decode the MP3 streams and output them to the I2S interface. Now we are ready. Now we can select our board from the board menu. We select this board, ESP32 S3 Dev Board. Before we upload our code, we have to adjust some key settings in the Arduino IDE to get our project working. First, go to Tools and set the CDC on boot option to enabled, and then set the flash size to 16 megabytes. This gives our program enough space. Next, find the partition sim and select 16 megabyte flaps and 3 megabyte up. This helps our program fit on the chip. Finally, and this is crucial for the audio, enable PSRAM by setting it to OP PSRAM. This provides the extra memory needed for smooth audio streaming. Next, in the code, update your Wi-Fi credentials here. The code comes with some Greek radio stations pre-configured, but you can easily replace them with your favorite stations. Look for the radio station array and replace the station names and streaming URLs with the ones you prefer. Once you have made these changes, you are ready to upload the code and start enjoying your homemade internet radio. You can find a link to the code of the project in the video description. If you found this project useful, consider giving it a like so more people can learn about it and have a chance to build it. Thanks. Before we go, let me show you the power consumption of this project. Since this project uses an AMOLED display, the power consumption of the display is very low. Check this out. The project draws around 150 milliamps of current at 5 volts. So the power consumption is less than a watt. Amazing. So if you add a big battery to the project, you can have this project run on this battery for many hours non-stop. How cool is that? I can't wait to build an enclosure for this project and improve it even more. If you want to see how this little project evolves, be sure to subscribe. Thanks for watching.